a basic guide on how to use FFsplit to record videos to your hard drive. Basically, these videos will be screen captures of what you're doing on your computer. First thing you want to do is get FFsplit. You can do that just by googling FFsplit. It's just ffsplit.com. The current version is 0609, that's the one I'll be using. And when you open it up, this is what you see. Pretty basic, nothing too exciting there. But if you go under Capture here, you'll see a whole bunch of settings. The first one you'll see is Video Source. You want to select the overlay, and then you go to Settings. And you can see here a lot of junk. But this is what you'll be recording. You see my desktop there. And you can see my little image there from my overlay. To do something like that, you would go to Images, find your image, and then use the XY position to place it. So let's say if I change that Y to 500, it moves that down. I'm going to change it back to 8. Not too much to it. You can do the same thing with the camera. Select your source. And you can see there I am right there. But do that. So you can have you and your video there. That's all there is to that. Click here. Direct show audio source. That's just where you record video or the audio from. If you have it on this, it records anything that comes out of your speakers pretty much. Microphone source. This is so if you want to record yourself talking, select your which one. The bitrate, if you're recording to your hard drive, selecting 3000 seems to be a good sweet spot. You get almost no quality loss. Preset, just leave that default. Video resolution, if you want the best quality, you set it to whatever your video resolution is. This is 1080p. My monitor is 1440p, but it gets really big, so I just leave it at 1080. Frame rate, unless you're doing something really high frame rate, 20 seems to be pretty good. Audio bit rate, unless you're doing music, video, or something like that, setting this to 64 or lower even, would be fine. And the same thing with audio channels. Now you just select record to hard drive. Saved to. And to change that, you go to Settings, Offline Recording Options, you hit Browse, and choose your folder in here. You can select the format, FLV for Flash, MKV, or MP4. I usually leave it at MP4, just easier to work with for me. And a temporary folder. This is where it'll store like caching stuff and buffering. Advanced options, I have no idea what that does yet, so whatever. Okay, and we're going to go ahead and try to capture something here. I'm not sure how it'll work, because I'm also capturing with Microsoft Expression Tool right now. So let's see what happens. Okay, let's hit start. And it should be capturing me capturing right now into this folder. And we'll go ahead and stop that and see what happens. And there's the folder. Go ahead and play that. And it seemed to work out pretty good. That's all there is to it. And once you got it, you can see here the file size is not too big. It's a pretty small MP4, pretty easy to work with. Now, if you wanted to cut stuff out and stuff using Virtual Dub, you would have to convert it to an AVI file, unless you're using your this to it, really. Nothing too exciting.